Halleluja! I don't know about you, but I claim it my season. This dear young man here with the black t-shirt, come here, son. I'm going to pray. You can be seated. Just lift your hands in the anointing. Praise God. God bless you. When I was a boy, 7 years old, Jesus came to me in a field, and he gave me a gift. And I thank God for Jesus. Praise God. This has been a tough last season for you. Isn't that right? At one point, the devil tried to convince you, just end it all. Isn't that right? And you sat out in a trucker car, can't see it clear, and you thought, this is the last night. Isn't that right?
RV, actually.
It was in an RV. Thank you. I see the vision. Something happened that night, and it startled you. And you looked. You said, who's coming? You thought it was a car because the light was bright. Isn't that right?
Yep.
That was an angel. And God sent the angel to keep you from committing an act of destruction. Praise God.
It was in the woods in the back of a horse farm. It was in the woods in the back of a horse farm, a mile and a half from anywhere. No light.
And you wonder where that light came from. The Lord has spared you for 2019.
The song just said, through the fire and through the flood. I moved from here to Kansas. I had some family problems. I moved to Kansas.
Now, let me talk to you. Let me talk to you.
You're, I got burnt out.
Just listen. You're headed the wrong way. I'm going with the Spirit. See, it's, when you're up against it, he started to tell us, but I'm going to tell you something different. Amen. God's going to restore everything the devil stole from you. You've had a little bit of problem in your stomach area. Isn't that right? You're ready to be set free. Praise God. Now, I tell people the Lord came to me as a boy. Some believe it, some don't. I'm at the stage of life, I don't care. It's about helping people to receive from Jesus. Can you say amen? Praise God. Praise God. Amen. I see an alphabet, A, B, C. No hepatitis shall set up in your body. Do you hear me? I don't know if you've been diagnosed with it, huh?
Yep.
Oh, glory. You're healed and God spared you. Amen. Come on, little lady. Praise God. You look nice today.
Thank you.
Happy New Year. Blessed New Year.
Yes, it is.
It's a new season.
Yes, it is.
We'll sing that again. Now, I don't know why the keyboard player, why you're pulling the anointing down. Either stick with it's a new season or hold your head in both your hands. Amen. We're in an anointing. Now, I'm going to tell you something. You're not going to lose your sight. Your eyes have been getting worse. Mm-hmm. One eye had pressure build up in it.
Yes.
Isn't that right?
Yes.
I see it now. Jesus is doing it. You woke up one day and there was like a reddish tinge in one of your eyes.
Yes.
That was a busted blood vessel. She shall not be blind under the command of God. Her eyes are healed. In Jesus' name. I love this man. And he knows how to dress. Glory to God. Someone say it's a new season. Say it again. It's a new season. Anybody here used to live in Washington, D.C. area? Anybody? You did? Stand, please. And you did. But I knew it was a man. When you came, you thought this was going to be a great opportunity for your life. But it's like almost sometimes You feel like the devil's been stealing your blessings. But you're moving into a new season like we've been singing. You believe that?
Amen.
Now, I break off what I would call thieves. People that are trying to rob you of what belongs to you. You understand what I'm saying? You won't need a lawyer for this. You hear what I said?
Yes.
Jesus will be your lawyer.
Yes.
And you shall have restoration of that which belongs unto you, declares the Lord of hosts, whose name is Jesus. Jesus. Everybody say his name. Jesus. Now, it's interesting to me how the Lord... We're not done, brother. Amen.
Amen.
I love you. God bless you. It's interesting to me how the Lord will speak to me. As soon as I said, I thought, what in the world has this got to do with anything? Washington, D.C. I tried to stay away from there. Someone said, what's your politics? I don't have any. My politics is I love the people. I don't care who you are. I love you. Nothing you can do about it. Praise God. And I see some preachers, you know, they preach strong about being Democrats. Some preach strong about being Republicans. When you do, you alienate half your people. Stay out of politics. Talking to preachers. Amen. I've been campaigning for my elder brother Jesus for 46 years now. I think he wins. And the government shall be upon his shoulder. Hallelujah. So, you receive a healing in your prostate today, and there'll be no complications. Power of God. Sing it. It's a new season.
God made the promise.
There you go.
He's through the test. He's going to open up a window.
Whoa!
Whoa. A lot of blessings.
Lady, when I came in, it was a little dark, so I didn't know who was what. As I walked in, the Lord said, lay hands on her. I didn't mean to startle you. I was just obeying the Lord. Amen. Everything's going to come down to normal in your blood. You have three things wrong in your blood. One, the sugar will stay at the right level. Amen?
Amen.
Do you check your sugar? What?
I have low blood sugar.
And how do you know that?
Because I check it.
Because you check it. Thank you. That's one. Second thing, even though you have low blood sugar, your blood pressure needs to be regulated. And God's going to do that today. With you, it spikes up, down, up, down. And the Lord is going to level it out. You believe that with me? I've never, my wife will tell you, in 40-some years, I've never said this, but also your vitamin D. Do you know about that?
One vitamin D.
Yeah, because you were low on vitamin D.
I was.
Isn't that right? All right, here's all three things, so you can have a good, and one of your eyes is being touched today. This one here. No more blurring. And when you wake up, it'll be clear immediately.
Amen.
Are you the husband, sir?
Yes.
You know, pretty much that's what I've been reduced to. Yes. Amen. I love you. God bless you. Is it all right if I pray for this lady? I command all these three things that Jesus has revealed to be done. Hallelujah. And, sir, as a bonus, in one of your knees... The Lord is healing it. Amen?
Yes.
How long have you had trouble with it?
Oh, I don't know.
Huh?
A dozen years.
a dozen years or so. That's a nice song. I'll write that someday. When you go home, you'll find that your knee is going to get better from this Sunday morning forward. Mark it down. January 6th, Jesus touched you. Hallelujah. I think we need a little bit more of that song. Sing it, sir. Well, it's a new season
to be blessed. God made you a promise. You stood the test. He's gonna open up a window, pour you out a blessing. It's my season to be blessed. It's my season to be blessed. God made you a promise. You stood the test. He's gonna open up a window.
I love that singing. Feel free to go with me when I go home. Amen. You ready for the Lord to touch you? I don't know who Rick is, but I heard that name, Rick. And so while he was singing, I was saying, what does that mean, Lord? And then I got to thinking, I know a guy named Rick Lloyd. And I got thinking about Rick because I've been praying for him. And the Lord said similar for you. God's going to regulate your income. And it will not be a struggle in 2019. Believe that?
Yes, sir.
All these broken promises, God's doing away with them.
Amen.
Monies that are owed you, one path. A fella in particular has to pay up, the Lord says. You believe that?
Yes, sir.
And it's a lot of money. It's not just pocket change. The Lord says he has to pay up. You believe that?
Yes, sir.
If I'm called of God, then I'm prophesying to you one of the best years you're ever going to have.
Woo, I feel it myself. Glory to God.
Hallelujah. And your blood shall regulate. Hallelujah. This is an unusual thing because you look like you could whip everybody in here. But sometimes your blood goes down. I don't understand it. That's just what I see in the spirit. When it does, there's a weakness that tries to come on you.
Yes, sir.
Isn't that right?
Yes, sir.
And then in your back, one of your discs over the years has given you trouble.
Yes, sir.
When Jesus came to me as a boy, he said, I'm going to give you a gift. You'll know what's wrong with the people. Then I, that is the Lord, he said, I'll make them whole. I'll heal them, was the exact words. I'll heal them. Someone say, Jesus heals us. Now, you got to admit, either I'm very lucky or the Lord really did come to me, because so far, you can see, God knows the needs of the people. And when that disc gives you problems, it presses against that nerve. You not only get stiff, but there's a little bit of a pain that you have to deal with.
Yes, sir.
You're not deaf, but you're starting to lose a little of your hearing.
Yes, sir.
As a sign to you that the disc you can't see is healed. Stan, I'm going to pray for your hearing, and it'll come back strong. Do they call you Cobb? Huh? Kyle. See, that proves it's a gift. I didn't even remember his name, and he told me 10 minutes ago. One ear's worse than the other, and sometimes you switch the phone to the other ear.
Yes.
Jesus of Nazareth. Lift your hands, because what God's doing for one, he does for everyone. Now, if you'll get in these meetings this week, there will be a supernatural impartation for increase. You feel the anointing coming on you? Don't worry, you're not going to fall. And if you do, I couldn't hold you up anyhow. Hallelujah. Recreate his eardrums, auditory nerves, hardness of hearing in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Come out in Christ's name. Open in the name of Jesus. Clear. Clear. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
My voice sound clearer to you?
Yes, sir.
Did you know you'd lost that much hearing?
Yes, sir.
Clear now.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Jesus.
If you hear a whisper, you hear anything. Well, it's a new season.
God made you a promise. You stood the test. He's gonna open up a window, pour you out a blessing. It's my season to be blessed. It's my season to be blessed.
The devil steals from you, he's got to restore it seven times. And what you lost sets you up for what you're about to get.
Season to be blessed. God made you a promise. You stood the test. I feel it.
A book written by Wyatt Earp. He said his life was defined by the battle at the corral, the OK Corral. But he said after that, nobody gave him any more problems. Are you listening to me? You've sort of been at a battle at the corral, so to speak. And the Lord says, the devil. Gonna pay you back seven times.
It's my season to be blessed. Say, it's my season to be blessed. God made me a promise. Hey!
3 months ago. Everybody say 3 months. I almost died. The doctor said to me, you're in bad, bad, bad shape. I said, I like your bedside manner. He said, I've never met anybody that didn't have any sodium or electrolytes in their blood. I said, shake my hand, because you're about to tell me I don't have any. He said, that's right, and I'm rushing you to the hospital. But what the devil meant for evil, God turns it around for good. I don't have one belt that fits me right now. I have to get me some suspenders. So if my pants go down, bow your heads and pray. For 47 days, I could not move, and I lost muscle. The therapist said, you're going to walk again. I said, I love your faith. I didn't know how. She said, by February, we'll have you up walking. But 5 weeks ago, I started. I decided not to wait for February. And after all these years, Jesus came to me again and talked to me about this year, talked to me about this meeting. And if you can hook in with me, we're going to see some mighty things happen. Amen. Hold your glasses in your hand, little lady, please. That way I won't mess them up. I've been known to mess them up. Your left eye, this eye here, God's going to touch it today. Will you believe that with me?
I will.
This has been a problem the last few years, and it's really disgusted you.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you get so mad if the devil's there, you'd slap him right upside his head. Because you've always enjoyed good health and strength.
Yes.
And then all of a sudden this eye thing goes wacky on you.
Yes.
Pretty good so far?
Very good.
Now when I was a boy, 7, Jesus came to me in a field. He said, I'm going to give you a gift. I told them back there, you probably heard. He said, you'll know what people have need of. Then he said, then he, the Lord Jesus. He said, I always say make them whole, but he said, I'll heal them. Hallelujah. There are 3 gifts that help us to act like God. The gift of faith, the working of miracles, the gifts of healing, or healings, plural. These are the power gifts. Everybody say the power gifts. Now, I didn't think I could do this, but the Lord told me to, so I got to do it. Tomorrow at 12 noon during your lunch break, I'm going to tell you some secrets about how to operate in the gifts. I'm only going to go for 45 minutes, 12 noon to about 1:45, so you can get back to work. Pastor asked me to do it. I said, I don't know if I can. I've been off the road for 3 months. I had someone tell me something I never heard my whole life. You need to put weight on. I said, okay. Well, I'm going to make the devil pay. You're going to make the devil pay. You, behind your eye, I'm not a doctor, so I don't know what I'm talking about. But behind the eyeball, in the optic nerve and muscles, there's been a deterioration. Are you aware of that?
I am.
All right, I see the vision. Vision means revelation. John wrote a whole book called The Revelation of Jesus Christ. Isn't that right? Someone said, you haven't read a scripture yet. I'll get to it around 3 o'clock. Amen. You don't have to move. It's just the anointing so strong on me, I don't know if I can stand. Jesus. Now, on that optic nerve, there was a rupture. And that was why your sight suddenly, just that quick, started deteriorating. Isn't that right?
It did.
I wasn't there in the bedroom the day you woke up and your eye felt funny.
You weren't.
Let's make that clear. I wasn't.
You were not.
I still have a sense of humor. Lord Jesus. Now, why is Jesus doing this morning? Several reasons. Number one, to prove he is real. Number two, to prove that the conventional wisdom of men doesn't work. God hath chosen the foolishness of preaching. God's chosen foolish things. And I'm the biggest fool you ever met. Because I believe him. So if that makes me a fool, whose fool are you? You. I'm not the devil's fool. Now, the third reason why God is doing this, he loves his people. Any preacher that's a real man of God loves people, whether they're men or women, black or white, rich or poor. Everybody is somebody to Jesus. Say that with me out loud. Everybody is somebody to Jesus. And you're somebody to him. Praise God. My wife's name is Bonnie Susan, or Bonnie Sue. That's a nice name, isn't it? Amen. And the Lord calls us, I believe, sometimes out of the problem into the solution. And I'm not talking about eye solution that you put in your eyes. I'm talking about his solution, which is the answer. Amen. Also, the beginning of arthritis in your neck. You want me to keep praying? The gifts of the Spirit are like headlights on a car. The further you drive, the more you see. Amen. Also, a pulled muscle and in your whatever that's called up there in the shoulder.
Amen.
You strained it. And then again over the holidays, trying to do too much.
I did.
Heal the woman, Jesus. Even as it was said unto me in that field. Recreate the optic nerve. Strengthen the muscles in the left eye. Oh, and sometimes the vision is like split. You look and you see two different things in that eye.
Amen.
Even today you had that a little bit. All right. Oh, every day. Well, can we get rid of it now? Okay, just a minute. Are you still with me, sir? Okay. I'm not going to jump in your lap. I'm just standing up. I got to take that out. Got it. Operation successful. Stand. Cover this eye with your hand. Look around and you'll see the split vision's not there. In the name of Jesus.
Jesus, it isn't. Amen.
Gone, isn't it? I just crushed it on the floor. Well, it's a new season
to be blessed. God made you a promise.
Told me I couldn't walk till February. I'm dancing now. Hallelujah. Woo! Glory to God. Tonight, everybody say tonight, I'm going to lay my hands upon every one of you by a promise that the Lord gave me during this season that I came through. He said, everyone you lay your hands on, I'm going to put in them a new strength for whatever you need it for. Oh, say a new strength. Brand new, sir. New strength. Something that you don't have now that you're going to need. When I first started preaching down through here in 1975, North Carolina opened up and no one else wanted me, but the folks, you folks down here, and God bless your barbecue, said, I never knew what a good pork barbecue sandwich was till I came down here. There was a black brother over in Windsor. He got up every morning at 4 with a hickory wood and take half a pig, and I'd go over and watch him how they did it. And I also got some free samples. I helped him with the wood. But let me tell you something. I can't believe all these years have gone by. How many years is that? Wow. 75 from 19. 5 from 9 is 4. It's just like the revolver. It's a 44. But I'll tell you something. I'm still preaching. I still believe Jesus saves and sets people free. Everybody say, tonight, with God's help, I'm going to lay my hands on you. And the Lord once again came to me a few weeks ago, and he touched me. I don't even know why he uses me. I'm a hillbilly from West Virginia. But thank God. Hallelujah. You're wonderful people. It's a privilege for me to be here to minister to you. But I couldn't do what I'm doing right now if it wasn't Jesus showing me what to do. Stand, please. You know this little girl behind you? Who is she? That's right. I could tell by looking. No gift. Lift your hands. The Lord's going to move in your home. The devil's tried to bring great division and attack. You were looking at a clock on a wall. For some reason, you said to the Lord, I don't know if I can go any further. Some people don't even understand why you go to church. Are you going there again? Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Now, even though everybody can see you're a young girl, you had a condition start coming on your body, and you don't exactly know what it is, but you have sometimes a feeling of distress, and that is in your spirit, woman. It's nothing physical. There. Sometimes you just don't feel quite right. Look at me. The Bible says our spirit bears witness one with another. Sometimes your spirit does not bear witness with some, and you feel it. This is the beginning of the gift of revelation in your life. And tomorrow, everybody say tomorrow, at 12 noon, I'm going to deal with revelation. And hopefully I'll have a new belt. I lost 35 pounds in 3 months. The doctor said something to me I never heard anybody say. You need to put weight on. Yes, sir. I said to my wife, go get food. You shall be anointed. This situation is coming to an end. And always Jesus brings the best conclusion. Oh, also you have a little bit of problem with your sinuses, your breathing. God's touching that. There it goes. Well, it's a new season
to be blessed. God made you a promise.
asked the Lord for this coming year, 2019. Where will I get the money for this next thing I got to do? You wrote down scriptures that you know of that promises you the blessing.
Yes.
You got aggravated because as you were writing, the ink pen ran out. Yes. And that's why there's two colors on that paper. Yes. You could only find a pencil.
Yes, sir.
Pretty good so far? It'll come to you in three increments, declares the Lord of hosts, 5,000. And you actually wrote down that number. But then you knew you needed more. Is that right? Up to 20,000 this year, above what you normally would have. Isn't that wonderful?
Yes.
You broke off a relationship because you knew it was hindering you spiritually.
Yes, sir.
You said, Lord, I'll do this for you.
Yes.
So God said, I'll do this for you. 20,000. Hallelujah. It's a new season.
New season to be blessed. Said it's a new season to be blessed. God made you a promise. You stood the test. He's gonna open up a window, pour you out a blessing. It's your season to be blessed. It's your season to be blessed. God made you a promise. You stood the test. He's gonna open up a window. God made you a promise.
Well,
you stood the test.
You stood the test.
Gonna open up a window.
Whoa.
Oh, you got a blessing. It's your season to be blessed. Your season to be blessed. God made you a promise.
A promise.
You stood the test.
Hold your hands out, sir. I'm going to give you from God more years of life. Every bad report is canceled. You understand that? Here's a few years. Here's a few more. Here's a few years. Here's a few more. And when you get to the end of that, ask him for more if you want it. Hallelujah. I see this infirmity like a string in your body, and it's affecting more than one area of your body. You understand that? The muscles in your lower legs, sometimes the circulation's not what it should be. You go to breathe and you get short-winded and you haven't done anything.
Yes.
Then you have this pressure in your chest. Isn't that right?
Yes.
All right, I'm going to take the string out. Wow, it was a long one. That was what the Bible calls the spirit of infirmity. Heart and lungs touched. Prostate touched. Circulation touched. Pain in the knees. Oh, there it is. Whoa, it's a new season
to be blessed. God made you a promise. This test, he's gonna open up a window.
write that song?
No, sir.
Who wrote that?
Norman Hutchins.
Send him an offering. It's probably the only song he ever wrote that had that strong of an anointing. I don't know. I don't even know who he is. You could be him. I wouldn't know. Hallelujah. Lift your hands. There's a bone healing anointing. Heals joints, bones, and ligaments. Amen. Not even muscular dystrophy shall set up in your body or any kind of atrophy. From this day forward, you'll get stronger, stronger, stronger. Amen. Better, better, better.
Sir, yes, sir.
Happier, happier, happier.
Oh, yes.
There it is. God's reversing the problem. Should Jesus tarry, you'll be running around here in high heels again. Moby Dick. No, I'm just kidding. This is yours. Now, see, I'd have said, no, not anymore. Not well. We're not talking about drilling a hole. You have to get to a place where you say enough is enough. I'm helping you. It's like my dear brother. He got so excited he wanted to tell us his whole life story. You short circuit the anointing when you talk too much. Is that right, Kyle? I remembered. You run and then I'll hit you. Never accept what the devil tries to put on you. Now, if someone tells you you're ugly, you don't have much choice there. I've had that happen. Praise God. Don't take this cane. But see, to that dear lady I was ministering to, this has represented her strength, balance. Do you understand what I'm trying to tell you? You received it, didn't you? Your eyes are already being touched. Aren't they? Are you glad you came? I don't think you normally come here, do you? Is this your home church? Proves it's a gift. I was wrong again. But think of the people in Elizabeth City that need to be here. They need this Jesus. To me, Jesus is very real. Not just because he came to me as a boy. I was in Reidsville, North Carolina, preaching for Bob Nolly. You talk about tight but right. That was one of the tightest Sunday mornings I was ever in. That's why I said to my son, you go over there at 9 and break it loose, and then I'll come and demonstrate. Because after 46 years, I'm not dumb. Maybe not as smart as I could be, but once the word is released in the atmosphere and the word is received, believed, all things are possible. All things are possible. Yes, Jesus. Now, I was in Reidsville. It was tight but right. Nobody moved, nobody died. Brother Nolly said, my wife's fixed a fried chicken dinner. Oh, I love fried chicken. I've put more chickens in the ministry than any preacher you ever saw. Because you North Carolina women know how to cook. My wife's from up north. I brought her down here when we got married. We went to somebody's home. They had ham, fried chicken, roast beef. My wife said, they got three meats. I said, isn't that wonderful? If you don't like one, you can eat the other. Then they had biscuits and cornbread. She didn't know what to do, so I ate hers. I used to be 356 pounds. Can you believe that? And when the grandkids started coming, I started getting the weight off. Someone said, what are you doing, Brother Shuttlesworth? Waiting for the Lord to keep blessing you. It's in the atmosphere right now. That's what I'm trying to say. The atmosphere is broken. The glory is flowing. So I said, as much as I hate to tell you this, Bob, I can't eat. The Lord told me to go in one of them Sunday school rooms and fast and pray. I went in there and I laid down on the carpet. I said, Lord, it was tight today. I don't know if the people even care if I'm here or not here. But we need you, Jesus. We need you, Jesus. We need you, Jesus. Our country needs Jesus. Where we love one another. I used to love football. Do you remember James Brown played for Cleveland? He just got saved and he goes to a buddy of mine's church in Cleveland. And he's all out for Christ. I was so glad he got saved. That just leaves the other guy that I used to follow, Joe Willie Namath. He's next, whether he knows it or not. I found out where he lived, and I bought time on the local television station to preach every week in prime time. Someone said, you went on just for one man? One soul's worth it. As soon as I said yes to God, a man called me and said, how much do you pay for that station? I said, I don't know. I'll find out. And that one man paid a whole year in advance for me. But I was going for one soul. I've learned some things about Jesus. He loves us. So James Brown has a great work among young people. And he's, what, 80-some years old now. So God does not gauge your life or your ministry by your age. He renews your strength daily. Daily. Whew. And as I was laying on that floor in Reidsville, North Carolina, I heard someone coming, but I knew that side of the wall, there was no windows or door. So I buried my head in my arms. I said, if that's you, Lord, I can't look. My heart was racing. Been a long time since he talked to me. And I heard the feet coming, and I looked, and I saw these. And by the way, Jesus isn't white. His skin is dark brown. And I saw these sandals. And I heard the Lord say, lay hands on everybody, every service, and I'll break it loose in this church. I did, he did, and you couldn't get the people to stop running, shouting, and dancing. I said, is this the same crowd from Sunday morning? They all look like they're on no-dos. Maybe that's the wrong one, I don't know. But anyhow, Jesus did the work. One man, he was in his 80s, he got saved. He was blind to one eye. He said, I got to be baptized now. Now, I was in Reidsville in February. It was cold. They took him out to a pond behind the church, and they baptized him. And when he come up out of the water, his blind eye came open. I heard someone say it was so cold it made his eye see. I said, no, he was obedient. And the Lord, the Bible says, giveth the seeing eye and the hearing ear. This week, the Lord told me there will be many people deaf healed. And having eye trouble, even as you saw me call out several, heal. Where's that lady? No split vision now? Praise God. Praise God. Jesus has a miracle for you. Did you receive everything I told you? Pretty good? Sound right? You want to change anything? The plot thickens. Because you have a problem with one of your bones and you're not going to have bursitis and shooting pains. Isn't that right? I always save the best for last. Brother Hagin told me years ago, don't tell everything you know. I called Rod Parsley last night. I said, there's a church in Elizabeth City you got to come to. And he said, set it up. So start praying. This place is going to become a revival center.
Hallelujah.
For this region.
Thank you, Lord.
One thing I like about being older than those guys, they still listen to me. Hallelujah. If you'll raise your right hand right now, the anointing that is right in this atmosphere and the Holy Spirit is in you. Here it comes up in you, stirring up the gift. Stirring up the gift. Lift your right hand to heaven. Jesus, I'm believing you. It's a new season.
God made you a promise. You stood the test. He's gonna open up a window for you out of blessing. It's your season. You will be blessed. It's your season. Promise, you stood the test. He's gonna open up a window, pour out a blessing. It's your season.
Well, to be blessed. Well, it's a new season to be blessed.
God made you
a promise.
You stood the test.
You stood the test.
He's gonna open up a window.
Yeah.
It's your season to be blessed.
To be blessed.
God made you a promise. You stood the test.
Hey,
He's gonna open up a window, pour you out a blessing. It's your season to be blessed.
I'm gonna tell you this. I was in a restaurant. And a young man came in with his entourage. The Lord said, I want you to buy all of their meal. I said, are you kidding me, Jesus? And I went over. Teddy, correct me, sometimes I forget names. And I said to him, the Lord told me to buy your meal. What's your name? I believe he said, William Murphy Johnston III. I said, you're going to be well known for your music. Is that his name, son? William Murphy. He said, who are you? I said, I'm the Lone Ranger, and I got to go now. And all the years later, they showed me yesterday his music has gone right to the top of the charts. There's a young man in my meeting. I called him out. I said, you're going to have unusual music. It's sort of like rap. I don't even like rap. But you got to tell the people what God says. And now Marty and Fern, they have what's called the Social Club Misfits. They're number one on Billboard and all the charts. And when Marty calls me, he said, Uncle Ted, it all started when the Lord showed you. See that? From this church and from that keyboard seat, the Lord's going to take this music around the world. Stay faithful, humble. Because only when you're humble can God use you. And the same prophecy I gave William Murphy III and Marty Santiago of Social Club Misfits, I prophesied to every one of you musicians. Because the gift that's in Sister Jackie is being imparted unto you. I don't know why they stick him way over there. You're a part of the blessing. Now, if you think it's going to be church as usual, you're not going to like the way I minister. Because I promise God, if you get me off this bed, I will do everything you tell me. I lay there for 47 days, couldn't move. I knew every crack in the ceiling, what needed painted. But he got me up, and I'm going. And I'm not stopping till Jesus comes.
Thank you guys for watching or listening online today. I pray this service was a great blessing to you. You know, the greatest question you'll ever be asked in your life is, are you ready to meet the Lord? Are you serving the Lord with all of your heart? You know, my main goal in preaching, my main goal in providing these online services is to see people accept Christ and come to a vibrant relationship with God. So right now, if you've never accepted Him into your heart, why don't you pray this prayer with me and ask Him in? It's that simple. You just say, Lord, come into my life. Be the Lord of my life. And God will make a dramatic change in your heart. And let's pray this right now. If you are ready to accept the Lord into your heart, you want to ask Him in, just pray this prayer with me right now. Father, in Jesus' name, come into my life. Come into my heart. Be the Lord of my life. I give you all of my sin, all of my past, and I pray you wash it away and make something beautiful of my life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. If you said that prayer, I believe God has come into your life and has done something amazing in your heart. Continue to follow us online. We would love to continue to be a blessing to you and your family.